Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's the final Friday of October here in the state of Georgia, and the smell of playoff football is in the air, and we have a treat for you tonight on our Football Fridays in Georgia web game. It is the Region 2 Class 4A Championship game as the Spalding Jaguars, number 4 in Class 4A, undefeated on the year 9-0, host the third-ranked Perry Panthers, 7-1. So far in 2023, in a battle between Region 2 foes. J.D. Arnett is on to kick it away for Perry, who won the toss and opted to defer. Meanwhile, back deep for Spalding, Cedric Evans and Kamari Berry.
Number 4, Cedric Evans. And number 18, Kamari Berry, back deep to return for the Jags.
So a number one seed in the state champion or a state tournament is on the line. We are thrilled to have you with us here on GPB Sports. I'm Wiley Ballard. It is a beautiful night for a football game. Time temperature is 69 degrees. Both these teams averaging 40 points or more during the season. We could expect to see a lot of fireworks offensively tonight. Live from Bill Haisten Field Memorial Stadium in Griffin, Georgia, about an hour and 15 minutes south of Atlanta. Here in Spalding County, the Jaguars, they've never had an undefeated regular season. This is their 24th season. And a chance to set some school history tonight by matching the longest win streak in school history. Arnett is ready, and the kick is in the air. We've got football in Spalding County. It is taken by Berry, who stretches out right side. He's tiptoeing the sideline across the 35, and a healthy return for Kamari Berry as the Jaguar offense comes out to the field. They're led by their quarterback, Curtavian Clark, the senior, standing 6 foot two, 205 pounds. Not only is he Spalding's leading passer, he's also their leading rusher, a chance to go over 1,000 yards on the season tonight. Last week, he threw for 174 yards, a second-year starter, and he lines up in shotgun with star tailback Robert Henderson to his left. It's first and 10, and Clark lets it fly deep. He's got a man open down near the 20, and it is complete! Cedric Evans with a home run play on the first pitch. They'll mark him down at the 8-yard line. That is a 54-yard pass, first and goal. Cedric Evans, the leading receiver for Spalding. Now they give us to Henderson, tries to go off right tackle before he is swallowed up by the front of Perry. First man on the scene, apparently Jarrell Pinkney. Henderson rushed for 92 yards last week and also accounted for four catches and 108 yards. Through the air, so he's a huge piece for this Spalding offense. It's a pickup of two. It's second and goal from the six. Clark sends Evans in motion. They give to Henderson again. He bounces outside, inside the five, towards the pylon, and on three plays,
number 11, Henderson with
Spalding is on the board as they march down the field in a blink of an eye, a minute and 1 second off the clock. And it's 6-0 Spalding. Man, that was quick. Henderson with his 12th touchdown pass on the season. Or a touchdown rush, rather. This is Hunter Gabel on for the extra point. 20 for 23 this year. And the kick is wide left, so he missed it. 6-0 Spalding.
Number 41 Gabel's kick is no good. Your score with 10:51 left to go in the first quarter.
But man, what a start.
Zero.
For the Spalding Jaguars. Hardly a minute into the game. Cedric Evans, the big 54-yard touchdown pass, his 36th catch of the season. And Curtavian Clark puts it in the belly of Robert Henderson twice. And just like that, Spalding's got the lead. And that has been a bit of a concern for Perry this year. It's something we spoke with Kevin Smith about, their head coach, who's now in his seventh season at Perry, and he said they graduated all but one starter from last year's defense, And they've had to learn on the fly in the secondary. Of course, this is game number 9 for Perry. He says they've gotten better with some of their busted coverages, but Cedric Evans got behind the defense, took the top off, and that was the big play of that 3-play, 62-yard drive. So Gavel's on to kick it away. And back deep. Setting it up shop at the 10-yard line. That is Corion Daniels.
As
we said, both
Daniels,
these teams averaging over 40 points per game this year. Could see some fireworks tonight. This is the 8th consecutive season these two schools have met. Perry's won 4 of those 7 meetings, including last year, 40-7. Down in Perry. Spalding picked up a big win 2 years ago at Perry, 31-26 in 2021. Kick from Gavel towards the far hash, taken on a bounce by Daniels at the 3-yard line. He'll streak up the seam, breaks through the first level. Man, he's got a burst before he is knocked down across the 30-yard line.
Number 3, Dwight
Terrell.
Stop
that time was made by Dwight Terrell.
Panthers return the ball up to their own 34-yard line. They'll start off 1st and 10.
So it's a return of 31 yards, and here comes the Perry offense, led by their second-string quarterback, Cullen McDaniel, their first-stringer, Colton Ginn, out with an apparent arm injury, a hand injury. They hope to have him back by the playoffs, but it is Cullen McDaniel, the junior, his show tonight, and Ahmad Gordon, their 1,000-yard rusher, to his right. They send Dixon in motion, and the hand is to Gordon. He tries to go between the tackles, wiggles back outside before he is swallowed up by Kamari Berry and company.
It's a loss of one.
Second down and 11.
Panthers will lose yard at 2nd and 11.
Perry's an offense. They're pretty balanced. 224 yards through the air, 200 yards rushing on a given night. Again, Gordon does much of the heavy lifting as he motions out of the backfield. McDaniel surveying downfield, throws it high, and it's tipped away. Great coverage from Cedric
Evans.
Evans
on the coverage. The pass will fall
as he was cloaking
Kiel
Sparks. Junior standing 6'3", and Cedric Evans, two-way player for Spalding. He had that 54-yard catch a moment ago, and now he breaks up that second down pass. 3rd and 11. 2x2 receiver set. McDaniel looking over the middle. Floats it that way, and it's intercepted. Picked off. Ronald Moore Jr. is racing back. 30-yard line, 25, inside the 20 before he's wrapped out of bounds by McDaniel. And Spalding lands another huge blow in the opening couple minutes of this game. Ronald Moore Jr.
That's number 1, Ronald Moore with the interception.
A Liberty commit, first team all region
all
a year ago.
To the Panther 15-yard line. It'll be a Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
So it's 1st and 10 from the 15, and Perry in danger of falling into a pretty deep hole here. Spalding has not attempted a field goal this year, so the expectation is that this is 4-down territory, even at this distance. Clark keeps it himself. And he is stopped after a modest gain. He was into the waiting arms.
Number 7, Clark.
Devon Smoot. Devon Smoot. Junior
led. Pick up about a yard. It'll be
Perry in their last game with 9 tackles. Perry coming off a bye, but defeated Baldwin in their last game. Their only loss this year was their first game against Haisten County, a 6A powerhouse. A gain of 1, 2nd and 9 from the 14, and there's going to be a big tackle for a loss. As there was nothing doing there for Robert Henderson as he has dropped way back.
They'll lose a handful. It'll be 3rd down and long for the Jags.
That was Jarrell Pinkney making that tackle. So ball spotted back at the 23-yard line, a loss of 9. 3rd down and 18. Clark with Henderson to his left. They get the play call from the sideline. Dropping back to pass. Clark stepping up. He's trying to evacuate, and he cannot. He will be sacked on third and long.
Clark is unable to scramble out of the pressure. He'll be dropped for a few more yards. It'll be fourth down and long.
At that time, it was Chaden Barber. His fifth sack of the season leads the team. And that's been an area where Perry has been awfully satisfied with how their defensive tackles have played this year. Again, they lost their entire defensive line, their entire secondary from last year's team. And, you know, Coach Smith told us he thought they'd be about average at the defensive tackle spot. He feels they've been well above average. So after the sack, it's fourth down and 22. Clark heaves it high in the air, one-on-one ball, and it is incomplete. Looking for Cedric Evans. And on the covers that time, Tavares Simmons. It'll be a turnover on downs.
Penalty was on the Jags.
There was a flag that came out.
The Panthers will take over.
And our official Chris Moore says it was against Spalding. Holding was the call. That'll be declined, and Perry will take over on their own 26. So that's a huge stand for Perry. You give it a big interception return down to the 15. And again, Spalding, they have not attempted a field goal this year. On top of that, they lost about 12 yards on that series. So they go for it on fourth, looking for Evans in the end zone, and no luck. McDaniel with three receivers split out to the left and a flag before the snap. This will be a procedural. No, it's going to be on Spalding. Offsides, and they blow it dead. They'll make it first down and five. Ball at the 31. This is the Region 2 championship game. Perry has won three straight Region championships. Spalding looking for their first Region title since 2004. High snap. And McDaniel whirls around and hands it off to Gordon, who is enveloped after a gain of maybe one. The entire front seven may have gotten credit for that tackle, but it's usually a safe bet.
Zach Morrow, then, with a host of Jags on the stop. So it'll be second down for the Panthers.
Tyquay Holland, Region Defensive Player of the Year last year, their big nose tackle wearing number zero. Also, Zy Barham in on the stop. So second down and four. A handoff once more to Gordon. Breaks one tackle. Jukes another man. Tries to spin out of one before he is thumped to the turf by Damari Jordan. That will be enough for a first down, though, out to the 42-yard line.
Panthers are able to pick up the first. They'll have the ball first and 10 from their own 37.
We're making part at the 37, so it's a gain of four, excuse me. And that's how a little Wildcat action is. Gordon hands it off to Rodarius Lewis, who picks up a modest gain on first down.
Gordon on the stop again.
And Damari Jordan again making the tackle. It's a gain of 4, second and six. Perry looking for their third straight 10-win season as well. They'd never had one prior to the 2021 season. And another penalty before the snap blown dead. This one's going to be against the Panthers. Like a little communication to Kari Anderson.
Offense, 5-yard penalty. Still second down.
So it'll be a false start on Perry.
Penalty will back the Panthers back up five.
So it'll be first and 15. From the they did not mark off. Oh yes, they did. I'm sorry. Second down and 10 after the 5-yard gain. And a handoff up the middle, and Gordon. A modest game, but that's going to be third down and a little long.
Panthers keep it on the ground. They'll get a few, but it'll still be third down for the Jag defense.
So it's a gain of four, third down and six. And Kellen McDaniel, we've yet to see him complete a pass through an interception on their opening drive. He sends Lewis across the line in motion. Got Dixon as the up back, and they give it to Ahmad Gordon trying to make something happen. Takes it outside, wiggles through one tackle, and he is wrestled down a yard short of the line to gain by Ronald Moore Jr. And now
number
fourth
eight,
down and one.
Stop again. They'll bring the runner down just short of the first down
marker.
Will
Perry go for it here? We're just halfway through this first quarter, 5.5 minutes and winding. Fourth down and one in minus territory. Perry looks like they're going to keep the offense on the field. And now a late change. You got 10 seconds on the play clock here. A little bit of a fire drill for Perry as they try and get the punt team on, although take the delay of game. I guess that's not the worst case in the world. Oh, Perry calls timeout. All right. They're a little slow making their decision. And with 2 seconds left in the play clock, they will take the timeout to avoid the delay of game.
Panthers. It'll be their first timeout of the half. And this timeout is sponsored to you by
this evening features a real fascinating coaching matchup because you've got Kevin Smith in his seventh season at Perry. This is his 30th year of coaching high school football in Georgia. His very first year coaching high school football in Georgia, he was the ninth grade offensive line and defensive line coach at Griffin High School, which of course shares this stadium with Spalding High School, and a wide receiver on that ninth grade team 30 years ago just so happens to be Spalding's head coach, Carl Kearney. So we've got a mix of mentor and protege here. Kevin Smith leading Perry, while Carl Kearney looking for the first undefeated season in Spalding High School history. Of course, Spalding High School wasn't around when Coach Kearney was playing at Griffin. So this will be Caster Engelbach on to punt. And Cedric Evans jogging towards the left. It takes a Jaguar bounce. And it's secured that time by Alex Brown. Jaguars able to
Panthers down
the field
the
a little
the
bit.
Jaguar 23
inside
from
the 25-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for Spalding from the 23.
First down for the Jags.
But both these coaches, on top of having a long history together, they've really done something quite remarkable with these two programs. Neither have a long tradition of winning. Admittedly, Spalding didn't start playing until the dawn of this century, but Perry, they had just one region title through their first 65 seasons, and now they've won three straight. And a region title here on the line tonight between these two schools. First and 10. And Clark gives it off to Henderson, who cuts back inside, and he is slammed at the 25-yard line falling forward.
Number 11, Henderson with the run.
The hit that time was delivered by Elijah
tackle.
Joseph.
Pick up about 3 second and seven.
At the Rover position for Perry. So they'll give him a gain of 3, second down and 7. Play action, and that pass hauled in, and a tackle broken by Kewan Davis. The senior big receiver, that's his fifth reception last
nine,
three games.
Davis
he's really gotten
that'd
into
for a kick play Griffin.
The mix here on this Spalding offense. So it's a pickup of 8. First and 10, ball at the 34. Spalding leading. They scored in the opening 90 seconds. It was a 54-yard pass that got the Jaguars first and goal, and Robert Henderson, their running back, took care of the rest. And a play fake as Clark goes around the right side. Kurtavian Clark, he may have another first down. Looks like the spot.
Clark with the keeper.
We'll give him a first.
He will scramble and pick up another Chick-fil-A Griffin. First down.
That time it was Jordan Donald taking him down, but that's a pickup. 11 yards, it's first and 10 for Spalding. And, you know, the Jaguars, they're not too subtle about what they want to do. It's either going to be Robert Henderson or Clark on the ground or Clark throwing the ball to Davis about 90% of the time. This time, it's Clark on the ground again, taking around the right side. He's got a first down into Panther territory, and he's wrestled down by his ankles out of bounds on the Spalding sideline.
He'll pick up another Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
And that was Trey Day making the stop, but another healthy gain, 20 yards, first and 10, ball at the 35. And why not? Clark goes around the right side again, third consecutive time he's gone that direction. A couple of flags come out as he hops out of bounds at the 30.
Hold everything. There's a penalty marker down.
And we'll see what Chris Moore has to say, our white hat. And a beautiful night here at Memorial Stadium. Region championship on the line. And it's going to be holding against the Jaguars. So it'll be a loss of, or a penalty of 10 yards marked off from the 33. So it'll be first down and 18. Ball at the 43-yard line. Well, we've seen three straight quarterback keepers to the right side. We see another one. And they send Davis in motion. Clark keeps it again, breaks one, two tackles, but he is sandwiched that time between Jarrell Pinkney and Jaden Barber.
Get back to the line of scrimmage. It'll be second down at about 17. For the
Coach
Jags.
Kearney wanted to see if they could stop it.
Penalty on that last play on the Jags.
Perry does. And it's actually a loss of a couple. Second down and 19 at the 44. Under 3 minutes to go in the first quarter, 6-0 Jaguars. Henderson moves from the left side to the right side. Four-man front for Perry. Running a 4-2-5 defense. Clark dropping back to pass. He's hit, but he gets it loose, and it's off the hands of his intended target.
Clark's pass.
That time it was
third down.
Keyron Brown, sophomore, has got just 8 catches on the year. Had it go off his hands, and it's third down and long. Two by two receivers. Clark stepping up in the pocket. He's going to tuck it and run across the 30-yard line before he is shouldered down by Trey Day.
Clark scrambles.
Jarrell Pinkney also.
He's close, but it'll be about 5 yards short.
In on the tackle. And because Clark's able to pick up 14 yards there, it all of a sudden is fourth and five.
From the Panther 30.
They're probably going to go for it here. We've got Kewan Davis and Keyron Brown to the left. It is Kurtavian Clark, and now a timeout is called, and Coach Kearney wants to talk this one over.
Timeout.
So 6-0 Spalding. That's the first timeout for the Jaguars.
It'll be the first timeout of the half. This time out,
we talked about Coach Kearney's journey.
Griffin and Locust Grove.
Beginning with ninth grade football at Griffin High School, coached by Kevin Smith, Perry's head coach tonight, now opposing his former coach. But it continued down to Statesboro. By the way, congratulations to Georgia Southern, picking up a nice win last night over Georgia State down in Statesboro. But
attention spectators,
you know, Coach Kearney,
on the home side of the stadium. No one is allowed
graduated
to
from Griffin High School
in stadium stands during tonight's contest.
1999, and boy, that's a tough assignment in the playoffs, taking on Lowndes and Valdosta. Not easy draws there for the Bears.
Fans also,
but he went down to Georgia Southern as a walk-on. He redshirted in 1999, didn't play his sophomore year in 2000.
All the walls,
and in the last 2 years, he started 24 games. 2001 and 2002 for the Eagles, really just, I mean, quite a story sticking with it. And that kind of tells you how much he loves the game. Yeah, that's some pretty serious commitment. You're going to sit there on the bench and taking practice reps for 2 years as a walk-on. Ended up scoring a few touchdowns by the time it was all said and done. Fourth down and 5. Ball at the 30. Clark dropping back. Throws against the pressure. And does it skip in? Intended for Cedric Davis. Incomplete. Whoa, hold on now. Yes, incomplete. That was the ruling. And so Perry forces another turnover on downs. And we'll see if the Panther offense can figure some things out.
Jags unable to pick up the first. The Panthers will take over first and 10 from their own 30.
So third drive upcoming here for Perry. Panthers with a 3-and-out on their opening drive, or rather, yeah, 3-and-out on their opening drive, and then an interception on their opening drive, and then picked up a first down and then had to punt on their second. And this pass is complete to the left sideline, bending it back in towards the numbers that time. And yeah, it's going to be a first down. It was complete to Khalid Miller. And again, 16 yards, first and 10.
But the Panthers do
Dallas
pick up the
Marshall
first.
Making the tackle for Spalding. Minute 18 on the clock. Here's the second first down of the first quarter for Perry. They hand off to Gordon. He jitters to his left and tries to surge forward. It's a pickup of a couple. You know, Coach Smith is telling us that, you know, the way he can make people miss, he can make somebody miss in a phone booth, was the way he put it.
Number 8, Jordan, and number 0, Holland.
And Damari Jordan and Tyquay Holland making the tackle, second down and 8. Like we said, though, it's a balanced offense. Colin McDaniel making just his second start of his career at the quarterback spot, a junior. Empty backfield, it drops back to pass. It'll, under a little bit of duress, scrambling to his left, he flails it towards the sideline of Spalding. He does take a hit in the process. It was Damari Jordan who got to him. It's going to be third down and 8 now.
Panthers quarterback
ball at the Panther 48, 36 seconds
back to
left
the
to go in the first quarter.
It'll be third down and long for the Jag defense.
I haven't seen Dakari Anderson get too many targets here in this first quarter. He's the lone receiver on the near side, committed to go play at Cincinnati next year. Third and 8. Play action. Going to the left this time. He's got a receiver open just tucked inside the sideline. And that time it was Corey Pettigrew. He's got an offer from Georgia Southern, just a junior. That's a nice possession receiver route.
They'll have the ball first and 10 from the Jaguars, 41.
Just getting past the sticks and setting up shot between the sideline and numbers. And Perry's into Jaguar territory for the first time tonight after that 11-yard pickup, and they'll be dropped for a loss. Ahmad Gordon, nothing doing there.
That's number 56, Thomas Case with the stop.
And Thomas Case.
Panther running back has dropped for a loss. It'll be second and 12.
Making the tackle that time.
Number 54, Davian Foster, was also in on the stop.
And now Perry will bring in a couple more receivers here. That's Khalid Miller and Rodarius Lewis coming in. And that's going to be the end of the first quarter. So it's Spalding 6, Perry 0. One quarter in the books. It's the Region 2 Championship. Our Football Friday web game of the week on GPB.
Zamaya, she's my point guard, but she's also like my silent killer. You know, she doesn't need all the hoopla, all the accolades and everything. She just does her job, but she does it with a tenacity that nobody would know.
Coming in high school, my dream was to always win the state championship game.
Hit one of the biggest shots that we needed at the time and did it without, you know, she didn't jump around, oh yeah, I did this. Nah, she still had that face like, I'm supposed to be here.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Down and 14. McDaniel looking to the left and a little too tall for his target, Corey Pettigrew, beyond his reach. And out comes the punt team.
It'll be fourth down and long.
For Perry. So Castor Engelbeck on to boot it away. By the way, we said Perry was not their quarterback. Coulter again, he also served as their punter, but he's out with a hand injury, so Engelbeck, sophomore, getting a chance to punt here. Pick is away. And Evans is going to let this one roll out of bounds. It'll be first and 10 Jaguars. Spalding looking for a little bit of a full circle moment
tonight. Panthers took the ball out of bounds at the 12-yard line.
First
from there, your Jags will take over.
Seismic win, if you will. Their
first
big win under Coach Kearney came in his second season 2 years ago, and it was a come-from-behind win against Perry. Perry had won 21 of their last 22 region games. They were number 3 in the state for Class 4A at the time. It was a road game in a hostile environment. Spalding, meanwhile, had lost 15 of 17 region games entering that game, but they found off to pull off a shocking win. And Curtavian Clark, their quarterback, checked in as a sophomore in the second quarter, and he's been starting every game since. Now looking for their first region championship in 20 years. Clark keeps it, and he's got nothing. Wrapped up in the backfield.
Clark with the keeper.
It was Elix Brown.
Should be second down.
He had an interception a couple weeks ago against Baldwin from that defensive line spot. They'll say he got back to the line of scrimmage, so it's second down and 10. Three wide receivers left. Clark dashing to the left side, and he's tripped up. Tough hands that time from Jordan Donald. He just got enough to get Clark down, but he scarfs up 9 yards here. It's third down. Actually, after the adjustment, it's going to be 8 yards. Third
Clark
down and two, ball to 20.
Almost breaks it loose, but gets tripped up by a shoelace. It'll be third down and about two for the Jags.
They give it to Henderson. Off left tackle. And he looks like he's going to have enough for the first down. It'll be close. Trey Day on the stop. Downs marker says fourth down, but they've moved the chains, so that'll be adjusted to first. He's got the distance, first and 10. Needed two, got exactly two.
Able to run and pick up a Chick-fil-A Griffin. First down.
Two by two receivers. Clark gives it off to Evans. A stiff arm around one tackler, weaving back inside, and he's wrangled down by the duo of Cassius Williams
Number one,
and Elijah Ronald Joseph.
Moore with the run, but hold everything. There's a penalty marker down.
I beg your pardon. That was Ronald Moore there on the carry. There is a penalty marker down. And we've got a holding penalty against Spalding. Second down and 9. Let's see where they spot it from. That's where we're currently at before the penalty adjustment. Now here comes the walk-off.
The holding penalty against the Jags.
Put
him at
the 13-yard line. So it's first down and 19, rather. Clark barking out signals. Play action. Buying time with his legs, throwing over the middle, and he bounces it in. Had an open man in Cedric
Clark
Evans, just couldn't quite get it to him
complete.
Off his back foot. And you got to give a lot of praise to that Perry defensive line. That's, I think, safe to say the two strengths of these two defenses are what they get from their defensive lines. And Spalding just the three-man front, but they've got three all-region performers from a year ago up there, including the region defensive player of the year at their nose tackle. And for Perry, I mean, between Trevor Hansen and Chaden Barber, and then, of course, Cassius Williams, who's been kind of their game-breaker at that defensive end position. So second down and 19 after the incompletion. Got to get to the 32. Clark stepping up, and he's throwing on the run. He's off target looking for Evans again.
Clark's pass falls in.
Third down and 19.
Everybody got third down.
So far, neither offense has been able to get a whole lot going here. Spalding scored in their opening drive. It took just three plays and 61 seconds. 54-yard pass to Cedric Evans from Kurtavian Clark, and then two rushes for Robert Henderson, including a 6-yard scamper for the score. Spalding missed the PAT. 5 seconds on the play clock here. Will Perry blitz? They will. It's a pass out into the flat. A lot of speed there, and Henderson might have the edge. He does, and he's got the first down.
Number 11, Henderson with the reception.
Clark identified the blitz.
First down for the Jaguars.
And Robert Henderson picks up a huge gain. And Spalding converts third down and 19. First and 10. Ball at the 34. Davis dunks it over the top, in and out of the hands of Ronald Moore Jr.
Number one, Moore with the drop.
It's kind of funny. That pass was intended for him. The pass that Kellen McDaniel was trying to throw was the one he caught on the interception. You make the pass, make the catch not intended for you. You can't haul on that one. So second down and 10. And a long little zone read that time. It ends up in the hands of Henderson.
Number 11, Henderson with another run.
And he's stopped
up
that time.
Pick up about three and bring up about third down.
Like Cassius Williams, it's a gain of three. Four after it's all said and done, in fact. Third down at 6. Eight minutes, 24 seconds and counting. Here in the first half, 6-0 Spalding. Clark looking to the left. Instead, will go over the top, and it's complete. Just inside the 50-yard line. Still racing down the near side numbers in a huge catch and run from Ronald Moore Jr. He may have dropped the last one, but he picks up a huge chunk of the yards after catch. Out to the 30-yard line. First down and 10. And it's Henderson who surges ahead. Pickup of about 3 yards. Second down and 7.
Number 11, Henderson with another run. He'll pick up about 3.
Jordan Donald making the tackle. Looking over to the Spalding sideline for the call. Kurtavian Clark surpassed 2,000 rushing yards in his career in this game at quarterback for Spalding. Sends Evans in motion. And they give it off to Henderson. And immediately with a bear hug that time, Chaden Barber.
Number
stops
Henderson with another strong run.
A little help
from
this Panther defense. Able to make the tackle. It's a gain of a yard. Third down at 6. Third down of the drive.
Bring a third down for the Jags.
They've converted third down and 19, third down and 6, and they got third and 6 again. And Spalding going quick, and a whistle before the snap. And we've got a false start against Spalding. So that makes it third down and 11 now.
Procedure penalty on the Jags. We'll back them back up to the original line of scrimmage. It'll be third down.
Again, this is likely two-down territory here for Spalding. You know, they don't kick any field goals. And I imagine when you're this far into plus territory, you're content just to take your shot on a fourth down if necessary. Henderson splits out to the left. Clark's looking his way. Now he throws it over the top, and it's intercepted. Panthers with the football, racing down the left side. This is Tavares Simmons, and he is tackled at the 43-yard line.
Clark's pass was intercepted. He was in on the stop.
And that's the first big play for Perry.
Their own 43-yard line. They'll take over first and 10 from there.
Senior with his first interception this season. We've also got an injured Jaguar down where the interception occurred. It looks like Keywon Davis, number 9.
We have a timeout for an injured Jag player on the field.
It'll be first down and 10, ball at the Panther 42 when play resumes. I believe this is Davis being tended to there on the 15-yard line. And, yeah, that is Davis, and he is not putting any weight on that left leg. He is literally hopscotching there to the sidelines. Big-bodied receiver. It'd become more and more featured in this Jaguar offense the last couple of weeks. And for Perry, look, they had a breakdown in the secondary, that opening drive that helped set up Spalding's touchdown in the first couple of minutes, but that was a big play that time from Tavares Simmons. Now it's first down and 10. Let's see if Perry can make something of it here, the best starting field position of the day. It's a high snap. McDaniel's pass is complete to Sparks. Kiel Sparks bumped out of bounds by Dallas Marshall. It's a gain of about three. Second down and 7.
Panthers complete the pass.
And we've talked about Spalding. They're really
– deferred out of bounds by Houston Jags. It'll be second down.
Don't spread the football around that much. It's really Henderson, Clark, and Davis. Or Evans, rather. Doing it for them. Perry likes to spread the ball around, and, boy, Cedric Evans was breaking on that route.
That'll bring up a third.
The target was Corey Pettigrew. Kellen McDaniel may have got away with one there, and – yeah, McDaniel making his first start last week with Coulter Ginn going down to injury. They feel like he's more of a dual-threat QB than Ginn. A couple interceptions last week, but Coach Smith said those weren't really his fault. One was the wrong call, and the other a tipped ball. And McDaniel airmails that one. He was looking for Corion Daniels on third down and 6, and he flutters it way over his head. He's had a couple overthrows tonight now. And the punt team has to come on for Perry. Right at the midway point of this second quarter. Spalding 6, Perry nothing.
He'll bring a fourth down.
And truth be told, Perry's fortunate that wasn't considered a backward pass. Could have been a live football. So he can go back on to punt. It's the third time today he's been asked to boot it away. And this is a high end-over-end kick. It's going to touch down at the 33. And picked up live by a Jaguar who's running the wrong direction. This is Elijah Whitaker who reverses course. And I think after all of that maneuvering, it's going to go for a one-yard return out to the 31. He thought he might catch the Panthers off guard. I think he also caught his team off guard. They weren't prepared to set up any blocks for him. And so Spalding, a 6-0 lead. Again, both these teams averaging over 40 points. And, you know, Spalding's defense has been really solid this year. That's no surprise. They've got a ton of returning players on that team. Perry, their defense a little less sharp, although now we've got a penalty flag that comes out. A block in the back comes out. And so that'll back up Spalding. And so – really, but just been better off just letting that one die there at the 30 or so yard line. So this ball is going to be spotted at the 16. So Spalding kind of gave up at least 10 to 12 yards, maybe more of field position there by Whitaker opting to field that punt on a bounce. First down and 10 for Spalding. Seen more turnovers and touchdowns so far in this first half.
Holding penalty will back the Jags back up to their own 15.
Clark in it, quarterback. He keeps it, and he's going nowhere. Hopping aboard his back, Cassius Williams. Also helping out is Ashlyn Ashley. It's going to be a loss
of keeper. He'll lose two
yards. Second down and 12, ball at the 14. Three wide receivers split right, a lone receiver to the left. And the give is to Henderson around the right side, and that defensive line for Perry starting to pick up on some tells here perhaps. That time it was Chade and Barber. Big number 96.
Jags pick up a couple on the run, but it'll still be third down and long.
It's a rush for no gain, third down and 12. And Clark may have to go to the air here. He's looking to pass. Pocket breaking down. Flag comes out. And a tackle from behind. A physical hit. Trevor Hansen, a senior who moved to Georgia back in January from Florida. So his first year playing high school football here in the state.
Spalding.
It's going to be a holding penalty against Spalding. Perry will obviously decline it with fourth down and long coming up. Clark does pick up 3 yards. Fourth down and 9, and now for the first time tonight, Spalding will punt.
There was a penalty, but it was declined.
It's going to be Kiel Sparks positioned to receive this punt from Hunter Gavel. Sparks is on the 50-yard line waiting for this kick from Gavel, who does it all, kickoffs, extra points, and punts for Spalding. And a chance for Perry to pick up their best starting field position of the day. And this is not a good punt. That's going to land inside the 40, take one big hop out of bounds. And this will be the Panthers' best starting field position of this first half.
Number 41 Gavel's punt takes a nice friendly roll at the end. It'll go out of bounds at the Jags' 42-yard line. 43.
So it's going to be just a 26-yard punt from Gavel. First and 10 for Perry. And, you know, you look at Perry this season, you know, their offense has helped them out a few times in some high-scoring wins. They had a 42-34 win over Howard, a 41-27 win over Dutchtown. Today is the defense giving the offense some opportunities here, and it's a handoff around the left side that time. Corion Daniels with the touch. He picks up a couple of yards for
Jordan.
Ronald Moore Jr.
Back, 22 bar,
takes him down.
Off. A 2-yard gain, second and 8.
Gain of 2, second down and 8. Under 4 minutes now left in the first half. McDaniel rifles it left, and it's batted away. Dallas Marshall trying to cover Rodarius Lewis. Third down and 8. And McDaniel just really struggling to find a rhythm in the passing game here. There's been some overthrows. There have been some tight windows. He just has not been able to find it through the air, and it's made this Perry offense pretty one-dimensional. I mean, take a look at the box there. McDaniel zips it into triple coverage. It falls incomplete. He was looking for Dakari Anderson, their top receiver. It's now fourth down and 8, and the punt team is coming out for Perry. They want to play field position here. Unless there's a fake in store. So Engelback. Slips and gets it off. Oh, man, that was almost near disaster that time as Cedric Evans evades the first tackler, but it's a dog pile down at the 10-yard line. And at the bottom of it, making the stop that time, Tavares Simmons. Forward progress will give him the 13-yard line. It's first and 10 for Spalding, 3:37 on the clock. Both teams with two timeouts left.
The punt. Punter's able to get it off. They'll start off with a Chick-fil-A.
Yeah, Engelbach, the sophomore. I bet his heart skipped a beat there. Region championship game, and you're getting pressed into punting duty because of an injury to your first-string punter, which also is the first-string quarterback.
With 3:37 left to go in the half, the Jags start with the ball on their
Engelbach,
own 14 yards.
Nearly lost his footing there on the turf. That would have been a huge, huge misstep. So first and 10, Kurtavian Clark gives it to Henderson, who finds a seam up the middle, and he's off to the races. Headed towards midfield. Look at him unwinding his stride. And he slows out of bounds as Trey Day had him cut off. but it is a monstrous gain for Robert Henderson. They'll say he went out at the Perry 30-yard line. That's a 57-yard run. First and 10, Spalding. And the chain gang hasn't even caught up yet. Clark to Henderson again, and we've got a whistle. And a flag comes out. And a false start against Spalding.
Procedure penalty will back the Jaguars up 5. It'll still be first down.
So first down and 15, ball at the 35. The fewest points Spalding has scored this season is 28. That was back in August against Mary Persons. They have scored 40 or more points in 7 of their 9 games this year, but it's 6-0 here with a little less than 3.5 minutes left to go in the first half. Clark tosses across to Henderson. It's off his right hand. Is that a live ball? They rule that it was a backward pass. It's a gain of 1. Wow. Or a gain of 6, rather. Second down and 9. They ruled that that
Henderson
ball
picks up the lateral and runs it back to the original.
Was a lateral.
Let me take it down.
Tell you what, a little questionable there. I mean, I don't think it was intentional, but he kind of did bat the ball forward. Either way, it's a gain of 6 on that broken play. Clark with the give this time to Dwight Terrell. And that's no gain.
Number 3, Dwight Terrell with the run. He'll pick up about 0.5 yard. He'll bring up 3rd down for the Jags.
Trevor Hansen, senior, making the stop. Gotta imagine this is 4-down territory for Spalding. They do not kick field goals. Not all that common at the high school level. Clark, a low snap. He handles it. Has time. Flag comes flying out on the near side as Clark dilly-dallying and dancing across into the red zone. But we do have a flag that will be a first down if this penalty is on Perry. And let's see what the call is. It came from one of the line judges. I think they're going to say an eligible man downfield, although that did turn into a running play. That was the signal, though. Hand to the head for Chris Moore. That'll back him up 5 yards. Makes it 3rd down and 14. Clock stopped at 2:08 here in the first half.
The field was the call. It'll back the Jags up 5.
Play clock still hasn't started yet. I think the official's trying to talk through this call a little bit here. That flag came out early on in the play. It turned into a run play. And I think Coach Kearney's bringing that up, that it's only a legal man downfield if it's a pass. And so with that, they're going to say that the play stands. It did seem a little fishy.
Correction, there is no penalty as it was a run play. So it will be a Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
Again, the flag came out as it was looking like it was going to be a pass play. But Clark, buying time with his legs, decided to scramble. And not only did they avoid the penalty, they also pick up the first down in the process. So first and 10 inside the red zone. Henderson trying to duck beneath a few arm tackles just outside the hashes. It's a gain of about 1.
Number 11, Henderson with the run.
That was Jordan Donald. 22 middle linebacker making a stop for Perry.
With a minute and 45 to go.
So it's a gain of 1. Second down and 9. Ball at the 18. And Clark. And Cassius Williams has him around his waist. And he brings him down for the sack. Oh, I gotcha. Clark was trying to scurry away, and Cassius Williams held onto him with the jaws of life that time.
We'll bring a third down and long.
Second team all region selection and last year, and, you know, Coach Smith couldn't say enough about Cassius Williams. He's their most impactful defensive player, just plays with relentless energy. And Spalding facing third down and 13 here. They're letting this clock run underneath a minute now. Not a whole lot of urgency for the Jaguars. This will be two-down territory. They have not attempted a field goal this year. Off his back foot, Clark heaves it high in the air towards the end zone. Incomplete. It's beyond everyone. He was looking for Keywon Davis. Good to see Davis, by the way, back on the field. He left early with what appeared to be a left foot injury. Now it's fourth down and 13. And for as much difficulty Perry has had offensively in this game, especially in the passing game, Cullen McDaniels just really struggled to hone it in. It would be a pretty massive victory if they can find a way to only be down 6-0 at halftime. Perry will be getting the football. But they've got to survive a fourth down play here from Kurtavian Clark. Dropping back to pass, and it's incomplete, looking for Cedric Evans. And I tell you what, there might have been a little bit of defensive holding going on there from Trey Day. The flag does not come out. I thought I saw a little bit of jersey. I mean, admittedly, we're a long ways away from the field here at the top of the press box at Memorial Stadium. But I kind of think that Trey Day got a big heap of Cedric Evans' jersey, but there was no flag, so with 38 seconds left, how aggressive will Perry be with Cullen McDaniel? And they're going to call a timeout here to talk about it.
Timeout, Perry.
We saw a 6-yard touchdown run from Robert Henderson in the first minute and 9 seconds into this ball game, and we've seen no scoring since. A couple of interceptions, but aside from that, a lot of punts and quite a few turnover on downs. As Spalding's been able to penetrate into Perry territory, they just haven't been able to finish out any of those drives aside from that opening series, which is really just three plays. It was a 54-yard pass.
Go into the restrooms or go into the concession stand.
From Clark to Evans, and then a couple of runs for the final 8 yards from Robert Henderson. All right, so first and 10, ball at the 21-yard line. Cullen McDaniel taking the snap in shotgun. Gordon to his left. 38 seconds left. High snap. They give to Gordon. See if he can make something happen. He's got some space here as he's out across the 30-yard line before Cedric Evans rides him down by the shoulder pads. Clock stops to move the change, and now it is running.
After they pick up the first.
First and 10 after a 10-yard gain, and the ball is on the ground, held onto by McDaniel. And Perry secures possession. And Tyquavius Holland with a tackle behind the line. And, you know, after that muff snap, Perry doesn't have to snap it again. They're going to say, you know what, boys, we're fortunate to be down 6-0 here with some of the problems we've had offensively. So two teams averaging over 40 points, a combined 6 points in the first two quarters of this one between Perry and Spalding, the Region 2 Class 4A championship game right here in our Football Fridays web game of the week. Happy to have you with us on GPB.org and YouTube.
Zamaya, she's my point guard, but she's also like my silent killer. You know, she doesn't need all the hoopla, all the accolades and everything. She just does her job, but she does it with a tenacity that nobody would know.
Coming in high school, my dream was to always win the state championship game.
Hit one of the biggest shots that we needed at the time and did it without, you know, she didn't jump around, oh yeah, I did this. Nah, she still had that face like, I'm supposed to be here.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Introducing the brand new app for Griffin Spalding County School System. It's everything Griffin Spalding County Schools in your pocket. This is the home screen. Tap the schools icon in the bottom right to select a specific school. Tap the three horizontal lines in the bottom left to see all the menu items. To turn on push notifications, tap Settings and select Push Notifications. The Events section shows a list of events throughout the school. You can use this button to add an event to your calendar, or tap here to share the event with friends and family. The Feed is where you'll find updates from administration about what's going on throughout the school, whether that's celebrating a student success or reminding you about an upcoming deadline. Search Griffin Spalding County Schools in the App Store or Play Store to explore the app for yourself. It's everything Griffin Spalding County Schools in your pocket.
We support Griffin Spalding County School System because we believe in having a positive influence in our community.
We are proud partners in education with our local schools. We sponsor the REACH Scholarship Program and the Continuing Education Scholarships for our teachers.
We offer several fundraiser opportunities such as Spirit Nights and selling Chick-fil-A sandwiches for concessions.
We enjoy catering events for our teachers, staff, and students in our school system.
High school students are some of our best team members. We offer employment experience, customer service training, and in some cases, college scholarships for our employees.
I graduated from Spalding High, went to Gordon State College, and now I work at Crescent Elementary School, all while working at Chick-fil-A on Taylor Street.
I'm a Griffin High Bear, and I love working at Chick-fil-A Griffin.
I'm the superintendent of schools, and one of the things that I love almost as much as my job is a number one from Chick-fil-A.
kudos and big shout out to the entire team, Chick-fil-A Group. Thank you so much for this partnership. Eat more chicken.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Memorial Stadium. Bill Haisten Field wrapping up halftime between Perry and Spalding. It is the Region 2 Class 4A Championship. The Perry Panthers, they've won this region the last three seasons. It's the fifth consecutive year they are competing for a region title. And before that, they hadn't competed for one since 1983. So, again, just a great effort on the part of head coach Kevin Smith to revitalize this program. And Spalding in a similar spot, looking for their first region championship since 2004. Just 4 years ago, they were 1-9. It's been a steady rise under head coach Carl Kearney. And they are two quarters away from their first perfect regular season in school history. If you're just joining us, Spalding scored in the first minute and 9 seconds of the game. It was a 54-yard pass from Curtavian Clark to Cedric Evans. That got the Jaguars first and goal from the 8. Robert Henderson, the running back, rushed a couple times, the second of which ended in the end zone, made it 6-0. Spalding missed the extra point. And that was it for the scoring. We saw an interception for either side. Ronald Moore with a pick for Spalding. Actually had the Jaguars at the Panther 15-yard line, but ultimately could not pick up a touchdown, and they do not have a field goal game. So they had to go for it on fourth. Perry, meanwhile, got an interception from Tavares Simmons deep in their own territory to thwart another Jaguar offensive drive. So as we get set here, again, I'm Wiley Ballard. Happy to have you with us. Big thanks as well to our entire crew working this game tonight. Greg Jackson, our cameraman. Nathan Sims, our producer. Reagan Smith on our graphics back in our Atlanta studios. We're coming to you from Griffin, Georgia. It's a beautiful night, and we are two quarters away from crowning the champion of Region 2 in Class 4A. Will it be the Spalding Jaguars or the Perry Panthers? We're going to find out. Starting now as Hunter Gavel booms it away down towards inside the 10-yard line. It is collected at the 6 and out to the 25-yard line. It's taken by Rodarius Lewis. First and 10 for Perry. Now the real question is going to be, can Perry get anything going offensively?
Walker in on the stop.
They've got Ahmad Gordon, who's rushed for over 1,000 yards this season, their junior running back. He's been quiet tonight after rushing for over 200 yards in their win over Baldwin 2 weeks ago. And then their second-string quarterback, Cullen McDaniel, pressed into duty with the injury to their starter, Coulter Ginn. He struggled to find a rhythm through the air, and they hand off to Gordon to begin the second half, and he is smashed by Tyquay Holland and company. Big number zero, the reigning Region 2 Defensive Player of the Year, and he lays a big hit. Start this third quarter. Perry 7-1, number 3 in Class 4A. Spalding 9-0, they are number 4 in Class 4A. 2nd and 10. Lewis in motion, high snap. McDaniel pitches out to Gordon, and he is walled off. Completely strung out and hung out to dry.
Number 13, Dallas Marshall with the tackle.
A great recognition by the Spalding defense. Dallas Marshall with the stop. Third down and 10, and look, I think it's pretty clear Perry would like to get the running game going. That was the key for Coach Smith. We spoke to him this week, and you know, some of that I'm sure had to do with not having their first-string quarterback, who they hope to have back available for the playoffs. Starting in a couple weeks. McDaniel dropping back to pass. Moves off the spot. Flushed out to his right. And off the hands of Dakari Anderson. Even if he hauled it in, I think he may have been out of bounds.
Number 20, Dallas.
So it's a 3-and-out for Perry.
Pass will be incomplete. A ring of a fourth down and long for Perry.
And it kind of feels like for the Panthers, it's going to have to be a home run play. It's just hard to see this offense right now stringing together a long drive marching down the field. So Caster Engelbach, sophomore, on to punt. And Cedric Evans takes the punt just inside the 40, and great coverage by the Panthers as they drive him back inside the 40. And there's some jeering coming from the Spalding stands over across the field. Thought the whistle should have been blown a little earlier.
Number four, Evans on the return.
But now Jaguars take over, first and 10 at the 38. It was their very first play from scrimmage that was their most successful, a 54-yard
pass. He returned the ball all the way up to
pass
the
down
Jack
to Cedric Evans.
From there, it'll be a Chick-fil-A and Griffin.
They did have a 57-yard rush from the running back, Robert Henderson. Sir Catavian Clark, who is now in his third year as a starter, or 2.5 years as a starter. He took over in the middle of his sophomore year against this Perry team. And Clark's going to run it himself, dancing around the right side. He's beaten the first level of the defense, tiptoeing down the sideline. They'll rule him out of bounds at the Panther 46. But Curtavian Clark.
Number 7, Clark for the keeper. He's able to pick up a Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
He has already surpassed the 2,000-yard rushing mark in his career tonight. And now they'll go quick. First and 10. Clark looking to run once more behind his big offensive lineman. That was A.J. Andrews. First team all region, big number 71.
Four to be second and 6.
It's a gain of 4 for Clark, second and 6. And I mean, you look at the stat sheet, you know what Spalding wants to do. He's not just their leading passer, he's their leading rusher when it comes to yards, carries, yards per carry. And Curtavian Clark, he stirs the drink. Now it's a handoff to Robert Henderson, and between the tackles, he bulldozes forward for a pickup of
number
a couple.
Henderson with the
it's
going to
be third down and 4 from the 39. This is 2-down territory, of course, for Spalding.
To the 39-yard line. It'll be second, third down.
I mean, they could conceivably punt, but that's not the way Coach Kearney has wanted to play it, especially given how successful his defense has been so far in this game. Under 10 minutes to go in the third quarter. Opening drive of the second half for Spalding after they forced a 3-and-out for Perry. Clark in shotgun. He keeps it. Falling behind Henderson, and he's taken down from the back. That was Ashley on the tackle. It's going to be 4th and 1.
He's able to get it close, but it'll be a yard short. It'll be 4th and short.
The question now is going to be, does Spalding opt to punt? Looks like they're going to bring in their Wildcat package here. Or they give it to Dwight Terrell, and he's stopped back behind the line. Turnover on downs. Big time stop from Trey Day.
Here Ty Holland, going to get back to the line of scrimmage, so it'll be a turnover on downs.
It was a loss of 1. I believe the give went to Dwight Terrell. Day with the tackle for loss. And it's first down and 10. Perry at the 37. Again, for a Panther team that has been carried by their offense this year, they're missing their starting quarterback tonight. The defense has stepped up big time tonight. McDaniel looking to throw. He's got Funches wide open, but he couldn't see him, and he is sacked. That time, Davion Foster, but Donovan Funch. Oh, my goodness, he was wide open on the post, or on the corner route down the seam.
Daniel Foster with the sack. It'll be second and long.
So it's a loss of 2, second and 12, and McDaniel just didn't recognize that Funch was open. Dropping back to pass again. Trying to buy time. And he just dumps it off to Ahmad Gordon, who makes a man miss across the 40. Weaving back inside, he slips. Also bumped down by Ty Holland. Pretty good improvisation that time by Ahmad Gordon. And that's the scatter report we got from Perry's head coach Kevin Smith. Ahmad Gordon can make anybody miss. So it's third down and 3. Ball at the 44. And Holland a little quick there, but he gets back in time. Perry adjusting the play at the line of scrimmage. Plenty of time in the play clock. It's a tighter formation. And it's to Gordon. Between the tackles, he's got the first down across the 50 into Jaguar territory. Anton Haven with the tackle. It's a pickup
Perry
of
able to rush to pick up the first.
9,
the ball
first and
10
at the Jag 47. Pretty nice recovery after missing that huge opportunity on first down to move the chains anyway. And McDaniel completes the pass to Dakari Anderson. We've been waiting to see him get involved. Team's leading receiver.
Number four, Evans with the stop.
Hasn't been a scoring threat this year, but he's been huge when it comes to moving the chains this season. They give to Gordon, punching up the middle, and he's across the 30. And a little bit of rhythm coming for the Panther offense now as that middle softens up after a couple of completed passes. And now an official's timeout, it looks like. Spalding going over near their sideline. And it looks like, yes, an official's timeout.
We have an official timeout.
Perry is going to be able to huddle up here. Initially, it looked like Chris Moore, head official, indicated that Perry couldn't go to their sideline to meet up. But then once he saw that Spalding was already huddled up, they said, all right, well, let's give everybody a chance here.
We'll give a quick shout-out to our cross-country team. Congratulations to the boys' cross-country team.
This is not a team timeout. I don't know why they stopped.
After finishing fourth overall in the region, the team members are Miles Stansberry, Hector Cruz, Jarrett Wilder, Walter Blaylock, Carlos Cruz, Amin Thomas, Sam Dirk,
the electronic bounce marker,
Joseph
Williams,
and Jonathan Palmore. The state meet will be Saturday, November 4th at 12:30 p.m.
I say that. It still says first down. It needs to be second down and three. Maybe they are having an electronic issue there. That still says first down. But it is second down and three. Or a long two, depending on how you score it. Ball spotted at the 29. We'll call it second down and two. And now the downs marker's got number two on it. And McDaniel hands to Gordon across the 25, and he's upended, falling ahead to the 20.
Number eight, Gordon with a stop. Perry picks up another first.
And Damari Jordan making the tackle, but that's another first down. This is by far Perry's best drive of the game. They're closing in on the red zone here. And it's Gordon who sledgehammers his way to the 20-yard line. A gain of one.
Number 13, Marshall with stop.
That time, Dallas Marshall.
At least second and nine.
And a stop to Gordon. And now Ahmad Gordon's going to get a breather as Corian Daniels checks in to spell Perry's 1,000-yard rusher. He's beginning to find a little bit of moxie here in this third quarter. They give it to Daniels, and he ricochets up across the 15-yard line. Wrapped up around the hips that time. That looked like Zy Barham making the tackle. And now brings up
third down and short.
And two. Ball at the 14. Daniels motions out of the backfield. It's a direct snap to Ahmad Gordon, who's near the line to gain. It looks like he's got it in the Wildcat. Ahmad Gordon moves the chains again.
Pick up the first.
You know, his brother Armar was the starting quarterback for Perry last year, now playing at UT Martin. He was the region player of the year as Perry picked up their third straight region title, and now they've got first and goal to 10. By far the deepest they've penetrated so far. Snap is high. Gordon searching for a hole, and he just ends up colliding forward for a gain of a couple into that mass of humanity.
Number 58, Anton Haven, in on the stop.
And they're going to get Anton Haven
getting
credit for the tackle. Now a diamond formation. Haven't seen this yet. As they send Khaled across the line of scrimmage, McDaniel rolling out. His pass is complete. Down near the five. Lewis into the end zone. Touchdown, Perry. Rodarius Lewis ties us at six. Well, that drive is primarily on the shoulders of Ahmad Gordon, but Cullen McDaniel did just enough and completes the touchdown pass to Lewis. And now a chance to take the lead. Zach Peacock, who, as you'll notice, is slight in stature. But he has stepped in as the kicker. And they say the play was blown dead before the snap. There was a pre-snap penalty. It looked like Spalding had jumped. They're going to clarify here, but you know, for Zach Peacock, a year ago at this time, he was a manager for the varsity football team at Perry. He went down to kick with the ninth grade team just because they needed somebody, and he volunteered. And Perry, their initial starting kicker for this season, was ruled ineligible. He was from the Ukraine, and he was too old to compete. He was 19 years old, as we do have offsides. The penalty is declined. They will have
offsides
to
on the Jags. It'll be declined. We'll
retry the attempt, and I think that's simply you just want to give Peacock a chance to get the ball airborne. He's plenty close enough. McDaniel is the holder. And Zach Peacock, a year ago, the manager, and now in the region championship game, he tries to give Perry the lead, and we've got, I think, another offsides penalty? Perry wants them to just, look, give us the points, but they keep blowing the play dead, and they have to retry the kick.
Offsides again.
And I think that's a rule at the high school level where you can't just let an
offside
play out.
The kick.
So they will take the penalty this time. Peacock. He's got plenty of practice now on this north end zone. The kick is good, and Perry has the lead, 7-6, with 5 minutes and 12 seconds left in the third quarter.
In the third quarter, Perry 7, your Spalding
Jags. Perry has their first points of the night, and they've got the lead. It was a touchdown pass from Cullen McDaniel to Rodarius Lewis. And the extra point from Zach Peacock. I think you look at that drive right there, and you got to give Ahmad Gordon a lot of credit. He found a way to make a lot of guys miss. There's a reason he's rushed for over 1,000 yards this season. And, you know, to Cullen McDaniel's credit as well, he did miss that opportunity on the first play of the drive, but he made just enough passes or completions. So Perry with the lead now. Their defense has been terrific. Gave up a touchdown in the first minute and a half, but since then they've pitched a shutout. And now J.D. Arnett is on to kick it away. It's a low line drive, one hopper. Taken on the far side. Out to about the 30-yard line. That was Kamari Berry on the return.
Number 18, Kamari Berry with the return.
This is a much different game than what we saw a year ago. 40-7, Perry won it. Even 2 years ago, it was 31-26. This has been a defensive struggle.
Keep playing Griffin, first down for the drag.
And, you know, the trend in these games, they've met 10 times. This is the 11th all-time meeting between Perry and Spalding. Only twice has the game been a one-score affair. It's usually been a blowout one way or the other. And the handoff goes to Henderson. Sparks up the middle across the 35, and he's wrapped up that time by Devon Smoot.
Henderson with a run.
It's a gain of
about six. It'll be second and four.
6 yards, second down and four. Under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Clark gives off to Henderson around the right side. He's got the first down, and Trevor Hansen has to rodeo him down, lassoing out to the 45-yard line.
That'd be a Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
So a gain of about eight. First down and 10, ball at the Jaguar 45. Again to Henderson, his third consecutive touch. And this time it's Jordan Donald who's got him wrapped around his knees. Pickup of two. Second down and eight.
Henderson with another run. Pick up a couple. It'll be second and eight.
This is a noticeable change, Henderson being the featured ball carrier in this drive. It really had been more Kurtavian Clark who'd been having most of the touches. Now here he keeps it, and he's out to midfield. Setting up a big third
Clark
down.
The keeper pushes up to 50. It'll be third down.
That was Jarrell Pinckney on the tackle for Perry. Will they go to the air here on third and five from midfield? No. Clark between the tackles, and he swung around just shy of the first down mark.
4 yards. It'll be fourth and one.
Jordan Donald again. Donald and Pinckney, Perry's two leading tacklers at those two linebacker spots in this 4-2-5. Now fourth down and one, and looks like a timeout has been called. An official's timeout. Yeah, because we have an injured Panther. Don't know who it is.
We have an official timeout for an injured player.
Going to bring up a huge play here, fourth down and one. Still plenty of time left. We're still in the third quarter, but we'd kind of been lulled into a little bit of a slumber with the defense and the punts. And that's Trey Day, who's now rising up a huge piece of the Perry defense at their safety spot. And he'll have to sit out this play here on fourth and one.
Just a reminder that we will do a
all of a sudden Perry
presentation at the conclusion of the game. Only coaches, players, and authorized game officials will be allowed on the field at that time. No fans, family members, or any non-personnel are allowed on the field.
Perry was able to score
the game
and put together a drive that we really just didn't see coming. And now Spalding having to answer. It kind of been in control of this game, although it was only a 6-0 lead. It felt a little bigger. And now it looks like Spalding's on to punt as they've got Hunter Gavel back ready to boot it away. Perry's not totally buying it here. They have nobody deep. It is a punt, and it's angling inside the 20-yard line and will bounce out of bounds on the Spalding side. So 2 minutes, 44 seconds. First and 10 coming for Perry. They've got the lead, and they got the football.
Gavel's punt rolls out of bounds at the 17-yard line. Perry will take over first and 10 from there.
Colin McDaniel making just his second varsity start here in the Region 2 championship game in 4A. A junior who began his middle school football career as an offensive lineman, played special teams his freshman and sophomore year at Perry, and now as a junior he's a starting quarterback with the injury to Coulter Ginn. And nothing there for Ahmad Gordon. And I think it's pretty simple if you're Spalding. You've got to make McDaniel beat you. And they did a good job of that in the first half.
Number eight, Jordan.
Gordon was able to make some pretty spectacular plays. That time, though, it's Damari Jordan dropping Ahmad Gordon for a loss. Second and 11. Ball spotted at the 16-yard line. 2:20 to go in the third quarter. McDaniel looking downfield now. Sends it over the middle. Intended for Anderson, and I think that's the right call. Pass interference is going to be assessed to Cedric Evans.
Pass ball is incomplete. There is a late flag.
He was way early making contact with Dakari Anderson before the ball arrived. And this ought to be a first down for Perry. Yep, they're moving the ball that way. It'll be a first and 10 for the Panthers. Again, we appreciate you joining us here on our Football Fridays in Georgia web game of the week. Class 4A, it's number 3 Perry against number 4 Spalding. A region title is on the line. And a give up the middle. Gordon's got space to the first level before being clotheslined there, just shy of the 40. Did the ball come out? A lot of stuff going on down there. Nope, Gordon's got it. It's a pickup of 9 on the rush. Pretty physical hit that time. I think it was Damari Jordan, who took Gordon down. McDaniel, that pass complete to Anderson, trying to do a little something afterwards. And it's enough to pick up the first down. Dylon Henderson. That'd be the brother of
Perry will pick up another
running
first.
Back Robert Henderson. Speaking of Robert Henderson, both he and Evans are on the field right now. Not used to seeing Robert Henderson playing both ways, but here in the second half, a region championship game, a one-point game, you're putting your best athletes and players on the field. This Gordon stretches out right side, and he pops out of bounds at midfield. A healthy first down gain of 6. And the running game has emerged for Perry in this third quarter, and it has made all the difference. Spalding's got to find an answer. Gordon again. He's got the first. He's got more inside the 40 before Robert Henderson drags him out of bounds. Ahmad Gordon is cooking right now. And after that first drive of this third quarter, I sat here and said, I don't think Perry's got a long, methodical drive in him. They're putting together their second straight long, methodical drive. McDaniel floats it over the middle. It's complete to Funches. Donovan Funch. Just his fourth catch of the year, but it's a big one.
Number 20, Henderson with the tackle. Perry will pick up
Robert Henderson making the tackle. It's first and 10 for Perry at the 23-yard line. And Gordon hit high that time as he sort of crumpled to the ground.
Tyquay Holland
is listed at 270, Gordon at 180. That's a 90-pound difference. Could be the final play of this third quarter. Second down and 8 from the 21. And this is Corian Daniels out near the 15. Nearly breaks a tackle. Oh, man. He was able to get an extra yard crawling to the 15-yard line before he was finally knocked to the ground by Dylon Henderson. And with 5 seconds left, will Perry try and snap it here on 3rd and 1? They will. It's to Daniels. He's got the first, and it's going to be first and goal Perry to start the fourth quarter. 7-6. Panthers lead the Jaguars. The Region 2 championship will be decided after this break.
Zamaya, she's my point guard, but she's also like my silent killer. You know, she doesn't need all the hoopla, all the accolades and everything. She just does her job, but she does it with a tenacity that nobody would know.
Coming in high school, my dream was to always win the state championship game.
Hit one of the biggest shots that we needed at the time and did it without, you know, she didn't jump around, oh yeah, I did this. Nah, she still had that face like, I'm supposed to be here.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
It's going to be a pre-snap penalty against Perry. A legal procedure.
Procedure penalty on the Panthers will back them up 5.
And now it's first and goal from the 15, and that Wildcat formation is going to be
first and goal from the 15.
Tossed aside as Cullen McDaniel comes back in. And it's Gordon jumping up the middle, breaking through inside the 10, and he's still struggling for an extra yard before Anton Haven knocks him down, but it's a sizable gain on a run up the middle, picking up 8, second and goal from the 7. Ahmad Gordon has been the star. I'm telling you, he is so elusive, so slippery, even in traffic. It's not out in space. It's between the tackles, and he's just able to slide through, contorting, maybe shimmying up between. And once again, he goes, and this time he's going to shimmy in for 6. Touchdown, Ahmad Gordon. Perry, back-to-back touchdown drives led by number 1. And Zach Peacock on for the extra point. And now perhaps a little nervous tension on the Spalding sideline right now. And they have not scored in nearly 3 quarters of gameplay. They scored in the opening 69 seconds of this game. And this kick is good. Perry 14, Spalding 6.
With 11:19 left.
11 minutes, 19 seconds left in this Region 2 championship game. And Perry, again, they're the team. They've won 3 straight. They've been here before. Competing for region titles is old hat. Meanwhile, Spalding undefeated this year. A win tonight would match the longest winning streak in program history for the Jaguars. It would also give them their first ever undefeated regular season. But right now, they're on the wrong side of the 14-6 score. The question you're asking yourself right now, if you're Spalding, you know, can you maybe get a little more from Kurtavian Clark and Cedric Evans as a quarterback wide receiver combination? You know, Evans, he had that 54-yard catch on the very first play of the game. He's caught a 20-yard pass or greater in every single game this year. I mean, he's a big play threat. We haven't seen him get many touches in the passing game since, as this kick may go out of bounds, and it does. Oh, a gift. J.D. Arnett, the freshman kicker,
will go out of bounds, which will result in a penalty.
Trying to do a little bit of a directional kick there. I think it was in the direction of Brian Kendall, the freshman defensive back on special teams for Spalding. But this is going to give the Jaguars some pretty good field position here to start. Well, it's going to be a pivotal drive. There's still 11 minutes and 19 seconds. We've just barely started the fourth quarter. It's a 1-score game. Both teams have 3 timeouts.
After the penalty, the Jags will take over on their own 35.
So it'll be first and 10 for Spalding.
First down.
At their own 35 after the kick out of bounds. That's the rule in high school. And so here we go. Kurt Clark going to try and engineer an answer. And he begins by keeping it himself. And Perry is just waiting on that. They are smelling it out right now.
Block with the keeper. Pick up about 1 or 2. It'll be second down and long.
And that was Jaden Barber again making the tackle for Perry. Second down and 9. Now Clark's looking to pass. And he doesn't see the man behind him. He lets it go deep, one-on-one. It's Evans. Oh, he makes an incredible catch. Wow. Cedric Evans hobbling off the field. I think he's cramping up. He is willing himself over to the sideline. A spectacular grab over his head. What do we say? Cedric Evans getting him the deep ball. And Spalding punching back, and all of a sudden, this feels like a little bit of a football game here. It was a slumber in some respects throughout most of the first half and early in the third quarter. But the offenses are finding some sparks. Long way to go. First and 10 from the 23. They give it to Henderson. He redirects up the middle, and he's popped at the 22-yard line, a gain of 1 maybe. Jordan Donald on the stop. By the way, that was a 42-yard catch for Cedric Evans.
We have an official timeout on the field.
And we've got an injured Spalding Jaguar. Panthers 14, Jaguars 6. And, you know, just put it in perspective the year that Spalding has had. They're 9-0. They've had only one win streak longer than 9 games. This is just their second ever win streak of 8 or more games. And they've only had 6 home playoff games in the last 24 years. 5 of them came in 2002 and 2003. So they've only had one since 2003. That was last year, a huge accomplishment for Carl Kearney. And this would be their first region title since that 2003 season. To put that in perspective, Coach Kearney was a senior in college at that time at Georgia Southern. And again, we do have an injured Jaguar on the field. We don't know who it is. The bottom line is this has been such a special season for Spalding and a chance to host the region championship here on their home field, at least their shared home field, along with Griffin High School Memorial Stadium. You know, what an opportunity for this group in just year 4 of what was a massive rebuild. Young man still getting attention just between the 20 to 25-yard line, laying on his back. Training staff on a knee next to him. Head coach Kearney with hands on his hips, gazing down. Meanwhile, Spalding's offense is huddled up near their sideline. Perry's defense taking a knee on the field out of respect for their injured Jaguar. If you're joining us late, Spalding scored a touchdown on their third play of the game. Made it 6-0. Perry has scored in their last two drives, take a 14-6 lead, and oh, this isn't a good sign. They're bringing the cart out from behind the end zone, and it looks like whoever this injured player is not going to be able to get off the field under his own power. I don't have a great look to, you know, try and see where the injury might be. There's just so much traffic and attention he's getting, so our view is a little obstructed, and especially now with the cart. And we will try to get you a number of who this is. But they are now bringing out a stretcher here. Place the stretcher down on the ground now next to the injured player. Got him on the stretcher now. It's about 4 or 5 coaches and trainers down on a knee. And now it looks like a couple of fans have come down, or at least clearly invested parties. You can only speculate, maybe that might be his family. And this, unfortunately, is looking more and more serious as this unfolds. There wasn't a whole lot of panic initially, but now they're bringing out the larger stretcher here. lift him on the board into the larger stretcher, it appears. They've got about, I'd say 10 to 12, maybe even 15 people out there. Just getting plenty of attention here, but you hope this isn't anything too serious. Now a round of applause as they get the player loaded into the traveling stretcher. They're strapping him in here. This is just a really tough sight. We still don't have a number on who this is. We apologize. Got about eight people bent over at the waist, making sure that this young man is strapped in. And now they're lifting him up. Oh my, this is Robert Henderson. His helmet is still on. His hands are laid across his abdomen. He's laying flat on his back in this car. Robert Henderson, who scored Spalding's only touchdown tonight. We mentioned he's been playing both ways in this region championship game. His brother's a safety for Spalding. They've got him in the card here, and we'll just kind of have to see where we go from here as they're now driving off. Fans applauding, but this is a scary sight. And we're looking for maybe a thumbs up or something from Robert Henderson, and yep, there it comes. He's got a thumbs up, moving his arm. Well, that's certainly a relief to some extent. Clearly, that's still a serious situation, but good to see him moving his arm there, giving a thumbs up to the home crowd. This is going to be a challenging spot here for Spalding in a lot of ways. I mean, forget the score, just emotionally, you see a teammate, and one of your leaders, junior running back, and again, the brother of another teammate, parted off in a stretcher, and now you're in the fourth quarter of the region championship game. You got to do your best to try and put this out of your mind, I suppose. Second down and 10, ball to 23 as we resume play here. Play clock will wind. Here we go. Clark. This pass complete over to Cedric Evans down the sideline. Oh, and he's staying bounds. He's got the first down. Looked like an egregious face mask there from Trey Day. And while he grabbed the hold of the pass, he did not bring Evans out of bounds. Therefore, he's going to pick up the first down, and I'm expecting a face mask penalty to be tacked onto this. Yep, it is a face mask on the defense.
Tack on a face mask penalty at the end of the play.
This is the goal, yes. So
it'll be a Chick-fil-A
it's
Brooklyn.
A six-yard penalty, first and goal from the six. Spalding answering. Perry's two touchdown drives in the second half with their best offensive drive, really,
first and goal
of the
from
game.
The
even their touchdown drive was just a three-play sequence. And the handoff is up the middle, pushing the pile forward near the end zone.
Touchdown!
Dwight Terrell with the touchdown. The backup running back having to step in for Robert Henderson, who was just carted off with injury. Terrell scores 14 to 12. And now here comes the two-point attempt to try and tie this game. So a six-yard run for Dwight Terrell. You got to credit the entire offensive line. A.J. Andrews, Jalen Laster, Ty Smith, Jonathan Sullivan, Thomas Case. All those guys up front, they're the reason he got in the end zone there. And the give is going to be short. They handed it off to Zai Barham, and he could not get in. So Perry still leads 14-12.
The two-point conversion
and
is
man,
not
we've
successful.
Got a good finish.
With 9:30 left to go in the fourth
ripening
quarter.
Ripening here in this fourth quarter.
Here's Spalding Jack, 12.
That is Dwight Terrell's first touchdown this season. Again, that's largely because Robert Henderson has just been the do-it-all running back for Spalding, but he is out. So 14-12 is our score. Perry had a real breakthrough back in 2020, winning that first region championship. But it always started with changing the locker room for Coach Kevin Smith. They felt like they had the schemes in place, they had the players in place, but they weren't quite winning as much as they expected. Got a turn to the classroom, the community, and it's kind of been that secret sauce that has gotten this team to the championship game. Straight down the middle, and a little bit of trouble perhaps. Corion Daniels gets it out across the 30. A flag comes out from the near side sideline. And got the ball currently spotted at the 33, pending the penalty. Question is, are they moving north or south here? It's going to be a hold against Perry
on the return team.
So they will move it towards the north end zone, backing up the Panthers. 9 minutes, 34 seconds left. A number one seed and the Region 2 title is on the line. There will be a trophy ceremony following this game, although Perry still
That'll
does have
the
one
return
more regular
up.
Season game
Perry
left.
Will take over first and 10 from their own.
They play West Lawrence
23.
Next week, but it will not impact the championship. So here we go. First and 10. Can Gordon continue to make something happen? They give it to him. He's worming his way through. He was following his lead blocker there. That was Colby
Haven
Dixon.
On the top. Second down for Perry.
Anton Haven again with the tackle. He's been playing big in this second half. So Colby Dixon with a lead blocker there helps Gordon notch 3 yards. Second down and 7, ball 26. Gordon again stuffed. No gain. Third down and 7.
Number 22, Zai Barham led the charge. It'll bring up a third down for the Jag defense.
Zai Barham with that last tackle. Perry has got to get to the 38. They'll say that Gordon did pick up 8 yards. So it's third down and 6. Play action. McDaniel going deep. He's got Pettigrew. It's a battle for the football. And it's intercepted.
And number 20,
Dylan Henderson
with
the interception. It was a battle between he and Corey Pettigrew. The ball was underthrown, and Dylan Henderson with the interception for the Jaguars. Yes, it was his brother that was carted off just a couple of minutes ago.
The Jags break over with a tip-ball Griffin. First down.
So it's first and 10 at the 47 of Perry. Plus territory, starting field position opportunity for Spalding. And while the Panthers had all the momentum at the start of this fourth quarter, punching in their second touchdown, Spalding has answered with a touchdown drive of their own. The second interception of the night off of Kellen McDaniel, the junior quarterback, making just his second start of his career tonight. And now Kurt Clark, who's a veteran, in the pocket, evading trouble. A whistle's blown. I don't know why. I don't know what prompted that whistle.
There was a penalty before the snap.
And there was a pre-snap penalty.
Delay game
apparently
on the
offense. The whistle just either wasn't blown quickly enough, or maybe it wasn't blown loud enough. But penalty against Spalding. We'll back him up to the other side of the 50. Second and 15 at their own 48. 8:22 on the clock. Keep an eye on Cedric Evans. He's the inside receiver on the left in this trip's formation. Terrell in motion, and it's dumped off to him. He makes a shoestring catch, and he's off loose down the left side between the numbers and the sideline, and he's taken down just around the 30-yard line.
Number three, Terrell with the reception. That'll be good for Chick-fil-A at Griffin. First down for the Giants.
That was Devon Smoot making the tackle. Rolling down at the 32. And a handoff to Terrell inside the 30. His number being called here. Second team all region ago.
Number three, Terrell with the run. Able to pick up about three. Second down.
Second down at 7. It's a two-point game, but again, Spalding has not attempted a field goal all season. And this pass is complete. Left side, hauled in that time by Keyron Brown. That's his first catch of the game.
Number 16, Keyron Brown with the reception.
And he's got it out of bounds just shy of the first down marker. It's going to be third down and 2. Ball at the 24. The give is to Terrell. He's got the first down, taking tacklers with him across the 20.
Number 3, Dwight Taylor with another run.
And Smoot made the stop, but it's first and 10. And now the Jaguars are into the red zone after that 5-yard rush. 7 minutes, 20 seconds, and counting. And Perry knows as well, if they just find a way to stop him shy of the end zone, they'll still have the lead. Field goal not an option for this Spalding team, as Terrell couldn't quite turn the edge quick enough. That time he was outflanked by Cassius Williams. Defensive end was able to run all the way from the other side of the line and catch him from behind. No gain, second down and 10, ball on the left hash now. 2x2, wide receiver set. Looks like Perry might be sending a blitz here. His linebackers are close, and we got movement. And it's a false start against Spalding. It'll be second down and 15.
Procedure on the Jags, we're back up 5. Still second down.
6 minutes and 36 seconds left in this fourth quarter. Spalding on the verge of what would just be a momentous win, similar to the one they had over Perry 2 years ago when they took down number 3 Perry as an unranked team. Now they face number 3 Perry as the number 4 team in their own right. A class 4A bout going down to the final half of this fourth quarter. And Clark keeps himself wiggling through. 10, 5, Clark, 6. Spalding leads! And he doesn't stop running! He is parading, gallivanting across the field! What a run for Kurtavian Clark, a 24-yard dash right up the gut. And Spalding retakes the lead. Hunter Gavel is on for the extra point. And the kick is good.
And the kick is good.
So it's 19-14 with 6 minutes and 11 seconds left. And wow, what a roller coaster it's been here in this second half. It was 6-0 at the half. Spalding with
correction,
the lead.
That would be 19.
Perry scored two touchdowns in a six-minute span
reminder,
of the game
the
clock.
Concession stands, if they're not
between
already
the third
closed,
and fourth
we'll be
quarter.
Shortly. The restrooms will also be closing at 6. Students, if you have someone come to pick you up, please go ahead and call your ride. So they are waiting for you at the conclusion of the game.
But Spalding, they've now scored
just
a pair of touchdowns.
In the championship
and
ceremony
a 3.5-minute span.
Only players and coaches are allowed on the field. No fans or unauthorized personnel are on the field at the conclusion of the game.
19-14. Now the question is, the defense for Perry kept them in this game long enough so the Panthers could come back, but now they're going to need a little help from their offense. And Cullen McDaniel maybe has to make a few throws here. As you imagine, Spalding's going to sell out and try and stop the run, because that's been what's worked for Perry so far in this fourth quarter. Deep kick into the end zone that time from Hunter Gavel. Well done. It'll be a touchback.
41, Hunter Gavel puts
and
everything
for Cullen
in that
McDaniel.
Game, a touchback.
I spoke to some members of the Perry staff, and the adjective they use to describe this junior quarterback is even-keeled. Doesn't get too high, doesn't get too low. And he's thrown two interceptions for the second consecutive game in these two starts, including one on the last series, which led to 7 points off the turnover for Spalding and a lead change. The question is, can Cullen McDaniel keep that even keel and poise here on this drive as he zips it across the right side? It's complete to Dakari Anderson.
Number 8, Jordan on the stop. It'll be 2nd and 2 for Panthers.
Well, that's certainly a confidence builder for McDaniel to throw that interception, get the ball right back in the air, and he makes a quality throw to the far sideline. And now they give this to Ahmad Gordon. And he's not going to get the first down on 2nd and 2.
Number 8, Jordan.
Man, that was
stop.
A big hit.
They'll bring up a...
Amari Jordan.
That'll bring up a third down.
Laying
defense.
A big lick there on Ahmad Gordon. Third down and short. 5 minutes, 20 seconds, and ticking. Stacked receivers pinched in. If you're Perry and you want to put the ball in the hands of your best player right now, that means you're giving it to Ahmad Gordon, number 1. They're going to the air. McDaniel floats it complete. A huge hit, but they've got the first down. Nice job of hanging on to the football.
Number 13, Marshall with the hit.
Khalid Miller.
But not before the Panthers pick up the first. It'll be 1st and 2.
Huge catch by the senior. An even bigger hit that time from Dylon Henderson. He needed 2, he got 3. 1st down and 10, ball at the 31. 4:40 on the clock. The region championship. Region 2, Class 4A, and Gordon stumbles on the handoff, lost his footing. He'll pick up maybe 1/2 yard. Maybe. In fact, they'll just put him back in the line of scrimmage. Both teams have 3 timeouts.
Panthers stumble on the run. It'll be 2nd and long.
But right now, Perry has the idea of a 4-minute drive in their mind to win the region title. That'd be their 4th straight region championship under Coach Kevin Smith. Empty backfield, Cullen McDaniel in shotgun. Looking downfield, and he finds a soft spot in the defense and drops it in the bucket right there. Again to Dakari Anderson.
Complete pass. They
their top
up
receiver,
first
team All-Region a year ago.
Just under 4 minutes left to go.
And it's a pickup of 11 there on 2nd and 10. 1st and 10, ball at the 42. They continue to march. McDaniel gaining confidence. Completes the pass out near the sideline and still in bounds. What an effort that time from Dakari Anderson. And just when the Panthers need it the most, Cullen McDaniel is showing some
Panthers
poise.
First on the reception. Be first
and
down
some
on
tact,
the Jags.
Taking what the defense is giving him. Time not a factor, still 3.5 minutes left. First and 10, now in Jaguar territory at the 48. They're putting it in the hands of their junior quarterback, just his second career start. Looking deep, dropping it deep, and it's incomplete. Looking for Rodarius Lewis, but slapped away by Cedric Evans.
It'll be incomplete. It'll be second down and 10.
Again, there is time to where Perry does not have to abandon their running game. But the last few snaps have been with an empty backfield. Ahmad Gordon lined up there currently. Spalding looking for their first region championship since 2003. And it's up the middle to Gordon, weaving his way forward. He's got the first down. He is just so slippery. First and 10, and Perry's going no huddle here. The clock winding to the 3-minute mark. Ball to 37. They give it to Gordon again. He loops around the left side, stretching out towards the numbers, spinning around a tackle, and he's knocked out of bounds by Dylon Henderson at the 25. That's another first down. And all because Cullen McDaniel able to move the football down the field, completing those passes, medium gains, that forced Spalding to respect McDaniel as a passing threat.
First time out of the half.
And that softened the defense up front.
This timeout is sponsored by Resurgence.
Gave Gordon some more space to run. Spalding calls timeout, which tells you right there, they're at a point where they need to conserve time. And again, the fact that Perry could really only pick up one, perhaps two more first downs, you know, this is going to be more of a question of can they keep him out of the end zone as opposed to can they keep him out of the end zone as the clock expires. I mean, they're going to have to force a turnover on downs, it feels, or create a turnover as opposed to get Perry just to run out of time, the way they've moved the football so far. Especially with the timeouts as well. Perry still with three. Man, both bands are dueling there across from each other on the north side of the field. Meanwhile, these two teams going head-to-head here. Last year, it was a 40-7 win for Perry. They turned over a ton of their roster. And even in this game, they've lost their top quarterback a couple weeks ago, Coulter Ginn. It's to Ahmad Gordon, left tackle. And he churns ahead to the 21. And on the stop, Zy Barham, along with Dallas Marshall.
The 2nd and 7 for Panthers.
2 minutes and 30 seconds left. The clock is winding. 2nd and 7. Ball at the 22. Will they go to Gordon again? No. To the air. Pettigrew is open. He makes the catch. And he's brought down by Dylon Henderson. But I think, yes, that's enough for a first down. Corey Pettigrew leads the team with
Barman on another stop.
4 touchdown catches this year.
Panthers do pick up another first.
1st and 10, 2 minutes to go. Perry needs a touchdown to Gordon. Inside the 10, the 5! Peter, Ahmad Gordon has given Perry the lead right back with his 22nd rushing score of the season, breaking his own record, which he set last week. 1:51 on the clock. And now the question for Perry here, do they kick it or go for two? Again, Spalding, they do not have a kicking game. I mean, normally you'd say, oh, go for two and make it a 3-point game. And looks like, yes, timeout called by Perry. They're trying to look at the score here. So, I mean, you figure there's only 1:51 left, but you figure if Spalding scores.
This timeout is sponsored by Bertram Septic Tank.
They've already missed one extra point
against
tonight.
Friends, if you, have
if you go for two,
game,
you can put yourself in a position for a field goal to force overtime at 25-all.
No unauthorized personnel are allowed on the field at the conclusion of the game.
But on the flip side, if Spalding scores a touchdown and you don't convert this two-point conversion, then you're down, let's say, 27-20, and you wouldn't have a chance to win the game. There's a whole bunch of scenarios here that could play out, I think. And, again, the fact that Spalding doesn't have a field goal kicker, at least they haven't attempted a field goal this year, doesn't feel like it makes as big of a difference. I think you got to go for two here, and you're anticipating perhaps Spalding, if they were to score a touchdown and miss the extra point, which they've already missed one tonight, you put yourself in a three-point deficit. That's Perry's line of thinking here. But they have the lead no matter what. McDaniel looking to throw. He's going to try and maybe take it himself around the right side. And Colin McDaniel has got the two-point conversion. Kevin Smith taught us that let him run if that's what it took. And that time it took a scramble from Colin McDaniel to pick up that two-point conversion. Perry 22, Spalding 19. And there's an injured Panther in the end zone. Looks to be a lineman.
Perry converts two-point conversion to push the lead to three. Your score with a minute 51 left. Perry 22. Your Spalding Jags 19.
If you had watched the first half of this game, you would have thought there is no way that Colin McDaniel would be capable of orchestrating a drive like what we just saw. Ahmad Gordon is not able to finish that thing off. The last 30 yards were gained by Gordon on the ground, if not for Colin McDaniel's ability to deliver quality passes, specifically to Dakari Anderson. It forced Spalding to respect the Perry passing game, something they really hadn't had to do all night long. But, man, Colin McDaniel, how about it? Just his second career start, just drove the Panthers down the field, about a three-minute drive or so. And with a minute 51, it's now Spalding needing to answer. This is Kamari Berry taking it around the left side, and he is lassoed to the ground that time. Colby Dixon made the tackle. First and 10, Spalding. They have just one timeout left. A minute 44 on the clock.
After the return, the
they
Jags
have
take
not
over
attempted
on their
a field goal all
yard line.
Season.
It'll be a Chick-fil-A of Griffin. First down for the Jags.
So they got to go 79 yards for a region title. It'd be their first in 20 years. Trying to dethrone Perry, who's won three straight and just delivered a championship caliber drive. Clark buying time, evading the rush, throwing it off his back. He's got a receiver, it's wide open. No one knew him. How did he get so open?
Number
oh my gosh,
Tyrone
it was T-Rod Brown.
Brown.
The biggest catch of his life.
The
sophomore. Just his 10th catch of the season, and he has completely turned this game on its ear. That is a 50-yard pass. First and 10 from the 29, a minute 32 on the clock. Clark looking to run. He's got no holes. He's in trouble. He evades a couple of tacklers. He's got a first down. I can't believe it. That's a circus-like trick. They'll not say he stepped out of bounds at the five. Kurtavian Clark, that was witchcraft. Absolute sorcery. How did he get out of that jam? First and goal from the five. The clock is stopped at a minute 20.
With 1:20 left to go.
They've got their jumbo package in here. Clark under center. It's Braham. The give is to Terrell. spinning towards the goal line. He's in! Touchdown Spalding!
Touchdown,
the Jaguars lead!
They
went 79 yards in 29 seconds. And this is a critical point after attempt here. Hunter Gavel missed one earlier tonight. And looks like a timeout has been called by Spalding. This is
timeout,
their
Jags.
Final timeout.
That'll be their final timeout of the half. This timeout is sponsored to you by Farm Bureau, Matt Murray.
So Spalding 25.
We're going to quick to our cheer sponsors this season.
Perry 22, and the question is going to be, will Perry need to get in the end zone, or could they kick a field goal to force overtime?
Kevin D. Oberg Construction, Hairology Salon, Haisten Outdoors, Countryside Automotive, Hillside, Griffin Stereo, Southern Pit Barbecue, Mid-Georgia Environmental, The Skid Haven, Rustic Aero Decor, Sweet Georgia Cotton, E4 Custom Fencing, Black Shear Photography, Squeeze Tees and more, LSC Service, Trinity Services of Georgia, and Franklin and Rosemary.
All right. Man, boy, has this Region 2 championship game delivered. It's hard to remember that this game, it was 6-0 with 6 minutes left in the third quarter. It's gone absolutely haywire here over the last 15 minutes of game action. Gavel, and it's a bad snap! It's a bad snap! And Zybraham couldn't handle it, and that means a field goal would force overtime. Wow.
All right, extra point is no good. Your score with a minute 15 remaining.
And Perry has attempted field goals this year. They've had a few different field goal kickers due to injury, not because of ineffectiveness, but Zach Peacock made his first field goal of the season in their last game against Baldwin. It was a 27-yarder. And Coach Kevin Smith, you know, this week told us the kick line is about the 20-yard line. They pretty much have to get to the red zone before they feel comfortable trying something. They did say that Peacock had made a 40-yard field goal in practice. But a minute and 15 seconds, Perry's got two timeouts. And that poise we were just talking about with Kellen McDaniel, he's going to need some more of it here. Because, I mean, just absolute explosions from the Spalding offense. First, it was the 50-yard pass to Keyron Brown. Then the 24-yard run from Kurtavian Clark. And then the touchdown rush. From Terrell. Second touchdown of the game, second touchdown of the year. And this is Anderson receiving the kick inside the five, weaving back up the middle, breaking a tackle, and he's slung to the ground at the 34-yard line. That tackle was made by Antoine Barkley.
So Perry will have the ball first and 10 on their own 34-yard line with a minute 9 to go.
Sit there and say they've got to get to the 20.
Just a reminder, at the conclusion of the game, no unauthorized personnel on the field.
That means they got to go 46 yards. And if they want to win it outright in regulation, they got to go 66 to the end zone. McDaniel to pass. Evades one rusher. He's in trouble. Floats it high in the air, incomplete.
Perry's pass, ball's incomplete.
He was looking for Khalid Miller. That was Maurice Hayes Jr. in coverage, who's committed to Bowling Green. Again, a turnover here would seal it for Spalding. Second and 10. Stacked receivers in a tight set. McDaniel Zips it over the middle, incomplete, looking for Dakari Anderson. Third down and 10. 56 seconds left.
That'll bring up a third.
Region 2 championship in Class 4A. Ahmad Gordon is subbing out. It's going to be a 5-wide formation. It's all on the shoulders of the quarterback, Cullen McDaniel, his second career start. Quickly lets it loose. It's complete to Miller. He makes the first man miss, and he is driven near the sideline, but ruled to be in bounds. Fourth down and 3. The clock is going. 40 seconds. Perry has 2 timeouts. They're not calling it. 33 seconds. McDaniel barking out. 30 seconds left now. Too much time is taken off the clock for Perry. McDaniel, and it's intercepted! Racing down the field! Spalding is going to win the Region 2 championship! On a side Barham, pick 6! Spalding will win their first region title in 20 years! What a tremendous moment for the Spalding Jaguars here in Griffin. That lead up to 9 now, a 2-score game. Third interception for the Spalding defense tonight. Zy Barham raced that one in, carrying the region title with him. Seconds left. A lot of the Panther fans heading for
there
the
exits. There is a delay game penalty on the extra point.
A delay game penalty charged to Spalding. Again, it's not all that significant. From 1-9 in 2020 to a region championship in 2023. And the extra point attempt is no good, wide left.
The extra point is no good, you're a star.
The Gatorade bath for head coach Carl Kearney has happened.
31.
He grew up here in Griffin, coaching now in Memorial Stadium, and he's going to bring a region title back to his
hometown. Just a reminder, no unauthorized personnel will be allowed on the field at the conclusion of the game.
There is now ice all over the turf here. Had a couple of Gatorade baths. And that's one of those where you'd really like to have that happen on the sideline or else after the game, but there's now ice on the Spalding sideline around the 30 or 40 on the Panther side of the field. Again, I mean, just from a math standpoint, you got 18 seconds. Panthers would need to execute a touchdown first, an onside kick, and then a field goal. Don't think they're going to be able to do all that here in 18 seconds, so it doesn't feel like these last ticks are going to matter too much, but again, there's a lot of ice in the field. Both these teams going to the playoffs, both top 5 in Class 4A. But Region 2 this year is going to belong to Spalding. Again, just a remarkable turnaround. And 18 seconds away from their first ever 10-0 season in school history. And this kick is fielded inside the 10-yard line. This is Anderson returning and still on his feet. 8 seconds left. He's racing down the field. And he's upended at the 30, and the clock will stop with 3 seconds left.
Bears having to return the kickoff all the way back to the Jag 30.
So a massive return, but just simply not enough time for Perry to do anything but get it to a field goal game. This ought to be
again,
the final
snap. If you have someone come to pick you up, make sure they're here ready to pick you up at the conclusion of the game. No unauthorized personnel are allowed to enter the field at the conclusion of the game.
And then it all broke loose. Absolutely haywire, and what a thrill it was to bring it to you here. Our Football Fridays in Georgia web game of the week. This one has got to go up as one of the best of the season, given the stakes. McDaniel drops the pass, and he is sacked! Spalding, officially an undefeated season, a region title, and a number one seed in the state playoffs. As the Jaguars, nothing but jubilation here atop Bill Haisten Field. And I think what you saw here was two teams that have that championship medal. We knew Perry had it. Spalding trying to take that next step, and they have done it. Dethroning the three-time defending region champs, the Perry Panthers.
Again, no unauthorized personnel should be on the field at this time. Please,
and the
no
Jags, 10-0.
Entering the field at this time.
Number four in our GPB rankings, and they will most certainly move up. Just a spectacular game, and I can promise you, whoever draws these teams in the Class 4A state playoffs, they're going to be in for a fight. Perry, Spalding, one of the best games we've seen this year. A big thank you to our entire crew, our cameraman, Greg Jackson, our producer, Nathan Sims, our graphics coordinator, Reagan Smith. I'm Wiley Ballard saying so long and good night. Your final score, Spalding 31, Perry 22. The Spalding Jaguars are Region 2 champions. And undefeated in the 2023 regular season. Thanks for watching. This has been a presentation of Georgia Public Broadcasting.
Zamaya, she's my point guard, but she's also like my silent killer. You know, she doesn't need all the hoopla, all the accolades and everything. She just does her job, but she does it with a tenacity that nobody would know.
Coming in high school, my dream was to always win the state championship game.
Hit one of the biggest shots that we needed at the time and did it without, you know, she didn't jump around, ah, yeah, I did this. Nah, she still had that face like, I'm supposed to be here.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Panthers. Congratulations to head coach Kevin Smith and the Panthers on a great regular season.